standing on this side to intimidate Joe. I am definitely the maid of honor, but I want to make sure you know where I stand. So I just want to say that Jeff, I've been in a lot of weddings and been maid of honor a couple times, and Jeff has been by far the best man I've ever wanted. Smoky to a point that like there wouldn't be enough space in this room for the two of us to function with other people in it. It was just too much. And we were Democrats, needless to say, we're really excited.
Yay.
You know, we look what's up. So it was exciting. Claire and I are also only children, and we lived together, and nobody died. As only children, we met each other when we were 18 years old, and a major growing phase of life that I think everybody's been through. You're in college, it's exciting. And as two young women, we became friends and then best friends. And then we became the kind of friends that become family. The kind of family you get to choose, which is, no offense, so much better. Claire gave me this necklace our first year of friendship, and it said some Latin word. It took Latin for 4 years. Yeah, it took Latin for 4 years, and she gave me this necklace. I said, Anankara. And that means soul sister. And that is a label I wear proudly. She is my soul sister. So against sister fashion, it wouldn't be very sisterly of me to not threaten Joe's life at least once in this speech. So I'm here to do that right now. I want you to know that I fully expect you to frustrate her. I fully expect her to call me because she looked down at her phone and did something silly and wasn't paying attention and be irritated. I fully expect you to challenge her and put her in extremely uncomfortable situations in life. But if there comes a day that you break her heart, and I want you to know that I'm a lawyer, that I'm feisty, and that I'll be the way to it. So I met Joe for the first time in 2011 when Claire and Joe first started dating, and they were both such extreme versions of their personality right now, and it's been awesome to watch them grow together, to change each other, you know, in an amazing way, to help each other figure out who they are, where they're going, and exactly how they're going to get there. One of the things that Claire and I always used to do is, we were 18-year-old girls, so, you know, we had a lot of fun coming up with different things and scenarios about how life was going to be and what marriage was going to be and like, oh my god, like, what is our wedding going to be like? And hers has been beautiful. They've made an amazing life together, an amazing wedding. And the thing that Claire and I used to always talk about is how when you marry somebody, you marry their whole family, you marry their friends, and you marry their life, you marry their dreams. And that's one of the best parts. So, Joe, you've been an amazing, amazing friend for the last 5 years, and you've been an amazing partner. I'm looking forward to the memories we're going to continue to make for 6 years. I'm sorry, I'm the worst. So, Joe, one of the things I wanted to tell you is that part of marrying our best friend, and by our best friend, I mean the bridal party and everybody else who's best friend, is that now, for better or for worse, whether you like it or not, you're a part of the family. We will advocate for your marriage. We, along with Claire's vows, we will vow to be a part of your life. We will get you through those valleys and those mountains that life can sometimes throw in your way, and we will be there to support you and love you. So if you want to give us a call, feel free. I won't always take Claire's side. I'll do my best. So, for the family that you choose, far and wide, to Joe and Claire. Amen.